And before we go, the Sundance film Shortcomings pushes the boundaries of Asian representation in Hollywood. Watch this.
It's an amazing opportunity, Ben. I'm really excited about it.
It only seems like an amazing opportunity because it's in New York.
Yeah, that's part of the reason why I wanted to do it.
Trust me, New York is overrated. It's so gentrified now.
How many times have you even been there?
Are we counting layovers?
No.
Look, it doesn't matter.
For many years, Asian actors were given very few opportunities in Hollywood to work. And when they were hired, not only were they often cast as inconsequential or sidekick characters, they also had to play repetitive model minority roles. The industry shift to be more inclusive happened in recent years, but the pressure to offer positive representation only for the community remained. Shortcomings is a step in another direction where Asian American characters have flaws and are allowed to have growth. In short, they represent people we may know in real life. Based on the graphic novel by Adrian Tomine, the movie tells the story of a struggling filmmaker whose own unacknowledged loneliness affects his life and the people around him.
Some actors may have second thoughts about playing a character who's flawed. Once you started filming, was there a point where that thought crossed your mind as well, or were you just so invested into this character and you knew that what he's doing is true to you?
First of all, Young, so great to see you again. I love speaking with you. I didn't want to get too in my head about how's this character going to come across? Will audiences like him? I mean, we have to let that go as actors. As you sort of mentioned, I try to just stay in the truth of the moment. I try to play Ben with as much heart and humanity as I could, even though he is quite grating at times.
Being able to play roles with flaws or unlikable moments was a privilege not automatically enjoyed by talents of color. Movies like Shortcomings fearlessly claims a space only enjoyed by other artists who've always been allowed to play complicated characters. Min, who also starred in The Umbrella Academy, Beef, and After Yang, explains how he related to his character.
Especially at the beginning of my career, I was really hypercritical about a lot of things, movies, other actors, other things. And you realize that a lot of that criticism comes from a place of insecurity, right? Comes from a place because you feel like you can't do what you want to do. So instead, you're going to sort of project that onto other people and other things. And through the help of many, many years of therapy, I've been able to heal from a lot of that. But yeah, there are so many things that I, you know, understand about Ben. And yes, Ben can seem like a certain way, but he is that way because at the end of the day, he's someone who's in a lot of pain.
Ally Mackey, who's also a standout in the Apple TV Plus series The Big Door Prize, plays Miko, a woman who explores her own identity away from a long-term relationship.
I think Crazy Rich Asians and all of those amazing projects really opened the door for us. And now, you know, like we always say, we're not a monolith, and there's so many different stories and characters we can explore. And I think Randall says it best in that, you know, if this movie creates conversations, you know, that's really what we've set out to do. Is it, if it makes people feel uncomfortable, if it kind of upsets what we've thought Asian Americans to be in this country, then that's an amazing thing, and I think progress. So just more of that, keep pushing it forward.
The movie features a strong ensemble cast, including film actors Jacob Batalon and Mike Cabalon. Directed by Randall Park, Shortcomings also stars Sherry Cola. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.